It's now my pleasure and privilege to introduce our first speaker this evening. Julie Borowski is a political commentator living in Washington, D.C. Sorry about that. She is best known for her YouTube channel, where she discusses current events in a quite entertaining way. Her videos have over 6 million views. She has won CPAC's Blogbash Video of the Year Award 2014 on her video debunking ObamaCare. Yay!
Yeah.
She was also rewarded the Tea Party Blogger of the Year at CPAC 2013 after creating a viral video. Welcome to the stage, Julie Brown.
Libertarian.
What?
Slow. I talked about legalizing drugs, bringing the troops home,
so I know what works. I know how to get the neocons over the bridge to libertarianism. You may have picked on the left, I don't know, but there's different arguments you can use from the left. You can approach it from, you know, talking about stopping the war, anti-NSA spying, and against corporate welfare, honest and fed. Those are issues, but I've learned more on how to reach the right. So, when I got involved really in libertarian politics in 2007-ish, I remember saying that I was a libertarian, and most people had no idea what that meant. It was more like, what? What is that? Now, we have a lot of haters, don't we? I mentioned this on the panel, that hate can be a good thing. When I started on YouTube, nobody knew who I was. I didn't have any haters because I had 50 subscribers. You're going to waste your time hating on somebody who has 50 subscribers. But as libertarianism has increased in popularity, we've gotten more haters. We've also got a lot of people who misunderstand what libertarianism is about. So the right, the drug issue. A lot of conservatives believe that libertarians endorse drugs. I get this all the time. Hey, some of you may, but not all of us, okay? I get this all the time, and I kind of said, okay, well, libertarians believe that you should put whatever you want into your own body as long as you're not harming another person. Still, a lot of conservatives don't get it yet. I kind of approach it from a cost issue. Taxpayers are paying black people up for drug use. So, you know, conservatives pay taxes, approach it from a cost issue, we're locking these people up in jail. When I was a conservative, I didn't realize how many people were in jail for nonviolent drug offenses. I was one of those, oh, they're in jail, you know, lock them up, throw away the key, you know, who cares about somebody in jail, right? Half of America, 6 million people are in jail for nonviolent drug use. Didn't know that, now I know. They have committed a crime. Use somebody else's views to your advantage. Most conservatives respect police officers. This is something that you're not going to change in one simple phase of debate. However, you can use that to your advantage. Law enforcement against prohibition. They have a lot of interviews online with police officers, mostly former police officers, talking about the war on drugs. Link to those videos because if a conservative sees a police officer because they're talking about the issue, they're not going to call you anti-cop. They're going to be like, oh, maybe there's a point in this. You know, I've always learned to use authority figures on this issue. Another way you can approach the drug issue is from a pro-life stance. I understand not everyone in this room is pro-life, but many conservatives are. Chris Christie, who I'm not a fan of either, but he was talking about, I saw this speech from him, he was talking about the drug issue from a pro-life stance. That it's easy to be pro-life when there's an innocent fetus in the womb, but it's not easy to be pro-life when somebody's a drug addict. And I was like, okay, he's showing compassion, he's approaching it from a pro-life issue. You guys watched another libertarian debate, but I watched the libertarian debate on Stossel last night, and they talked about the heroin issue. And I'll be honest, I didn't like their answers because it came across as, so what, the heroin issue in this country. This is affecting a lot of small towns in America, a lot of conservative towns, a lot of good families are being poor and poor by heroin in this nation. And I thought, okay, instead of just saying, oh, it's just a freedom issue, you know, talk about how government punishment is not the solution to the problem. Also, people are getting addicted to heroin through prescription medication. Maybe if the topic is drugs, talk about medical marijuana being a better issue than these opiates that people get addicted to. I felt like there wasn't enough sympathy for this issue that affects a lot of conservative families. So I've learned from you guys, you know, talk about the cost of the issue, also show sympathy because drug use is a horrible thing. It's not just a thing that just affects you as an individual. If you have a family, that's going to affect your children, your wife, your husband. This is an issue that I feel like we can get conservatives on, but just a different thing. Another one that I know I get all the time, when talking about I get that because I used to be on yoga ergo. I understand where they're coming from. Things that I've learned is that the terms that you use matter. I love the phrase America first foreign policy when talking to conservatives, because who's going to argue against that if you're patriotic American? So another one is big government foreign policy. Conservatives hate big government. So they talk about big government health care, they hate that. But it makes them, once again, playing the seed. When you talk about big government foreign policy, they're saying, okay, this nation building, policing the world, hey, that's big government too. Because as crazy as it sounds, when I was a neoconservative, I didn't think about the government running foreign policy. You know, I distrusted the government on domestic policy, but when it came to foreign policy, like, I thought that was a separate thing. Like, politicians become angels on that or some kind of silly stuff. But it's really just reminding them, this is the government. You really trust the government. Cost issue again. We're $19 trillion in debt. We can't really afford to be the world police then. Another one, and I mentioned this earlier on the panel, is to frame it as anti-Obama. When you talk about Obama's foreign policy, Obama's a warmonger, of course, but also the conservatives are against that. It is kind of partisan, but it really gets you're spinning. Once again, authority figures are really important when talking to conservatives on this issue. Because I know when I talk about the military and foreign policy to conservatives, they look at me like a little girl. Like, what the heck does this girl know about military? They think of me as like I'm a Bernie supporter, like I'm all peace and love, hippie. Like, if you can find somebody in the military who's anti-war, and there are Iraq veterans against the war, showing that there are authority figures out there who are against the war, it really gets the fear spinning, as opposed to somebody like me who's never been in the military, you know, criticizing the wars. So I've also been dealing with a lot of Bernie Sanders supporters over the past couple days. I released a video about how Bernie's going to raise taxes on everyone. I posted it on my Facebook. I think it had like 700,000 views, which is a great thing. But there's a lot of Bernie supporters in my inbox right now calling me all kinds of nasty names. But they believe that I'm this evil person because I don't support universal health care. That, you know, I must be against poor people. It's kind of like, okay, how am I going to approach this issue to them, right? Because it's difficult, because they have this detailed government plan on how to run healthcare. When libertarians talk about healthcare, we just say, let the free market do the thing, which is true, but like, people can't envision that. People want, okay, how is that going to work? What's your plan? What is that? It's really, really frustrating. But what I've learned from watching the left, from watching Obama, is they tell stories. If you watch the State of the Union address, Obama's always calling on somebody in the audience and saying, you know, this single mother who has breast cancer has health insurance thanks to Obamacare, right? Our side doesn't really do that kind of thing. I know a lot of libertarians who think, emotion, that's for liberals, you know. It's like, okay, we have the facts on our side. We can also show emotion if we're right to actually advance the message. There are people in Canada who are dying because they can't get a simple doctor's appointment. But we're not really telling their story. We're just showing a bunch of graphs or whatever, which really doesn't get to people. So I think the left is really good at showing emotion. Their ideas suck. But they're good at showing emotion to their point across, which I think we can do, and that's not a bad thing. Another one, and I got in trouble for this one too, is that libertarians, we must hate old people. This has to do with Social Security. This is especially true with Republicans. I feel like Republicans, they will not touch Social Security, even when it comes to like raising their retirement age a year or two, because the left is going to attack them. They're going to say, oh, they want to throw Granny off the cliff. All those ads, and libertarians, we tend to be even more radical on that issue. So I think, okay, how can we convince the left that we cannot hate all people. And I think last week, a lot of young people are kind of standing up against Social Security. A lot of young people are mad about their student loan debt. Big issue. But they're not really mad about Social Security. They're taking money out of their paycheck every month that they're never, ever, ever going to see. That should piss off young people. What's really strange to me, and like I said, I've never been on the left, but young people, they tend to be so anti-authority. They tend to be, you know, I want control over my life, but when it comes to these ideas, like, why would they support mandatory government programs? There's something off there. I wish we could kind of tap into that and say, okay, what's really happening there? Another thing, I've got a lot of messages from Bernie Sanders supporters, is that we involve these big corporations. There's two camps right now in my inbox. The first camp is people saying that I'm a privileged white girl, and you know, I come from this rich family, which I don't. And then there's another camp saying, you know, why do you support the 1%? They're just making money off of you, they're taking your money. It's so strange that they are so against rich people. Yeah. Now, of course, there are two different kinds of rich people, right? There's the bad or negative symbol who actually make money off the government. There are, you know, the Wall Street people on Wall Street who got the bailouts, government handouts. But then there's like the good rich people, right? That actually produce something in society that people really bought. And it's so sad that we just attract the 1%. I just don't get it. I don't know how to tap into that. And then there's people who think, oh, libertarians, you guys want monopolies, or which is very strange because in a free market system, monopolies very rarely happen. People think that these big corporations, these big businesses are lobbying for fewer government regulations, but actually that's usually not the case. They are actually, Philip Morris, Starbucks, McDonald's, they actually lobby for more government regulation, which sounds counterproductive, but they can afford the regulation. What they're doing is they're putting their competitors out of business, which hurts, which actually helps them in the long run. It's so strange that these liberals are so against Walmart, who gets government handouts, but they don't understand that Walmart is actually lobbying for more government regulation. They're actually for minimum wage increases. You don't get that because Walmart's for that because they want to put the mom and pop shops out of business. And I wish you could reach out to these lefties and be like, okay, this is what's happening. This is actually not capitalism that we claim to hate. This is corporatism. So I kind of want to. Messaging that we